strips.
I don't know how long it's going.
You guys sell phone chargers? Phone chargers? Yeah. All right, how about like this?
All right. Continue what you said.
Since you was in Psalms, we're going to come to Psalms.
Psalms, I was in Psalm 7.
You started at 5. Psalms 5 and 9. There is no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward part is very wickedness. The throat is an open sepulcher. I didn't say sepulcher.
Yeah, well, sepulcher is pretty close enough. Read that again from the top. That's a good scripture. Because look, this describes these people out here in America perfectly. To a T. Perfectly.
But there is no, Psalms 5 and 9. But there is no, but there's no faithfulness in their mouth. Their inward thought is very wickedness. The throat is an open
sepulcher.
Sepulcher.
A sepulcher is a tomb. The throat is a tomb. They speak the words of death. You know what I'm saying? Because that's going to be their end is death. They're going to eat worms. Or the worms are going to eat them.
They flatter with their tongue. Destroy thou them, O God. Let them fall by their own counsel. Cast them out in the multitude of the transgressions, for they have rebelled against thee.
That's a nice scripture. Yeah, these people have rebelled against the Most High, going back to that gay marriage. You can't stop talking about that enough. They actually legalized homosexual marriage in America. They actually put the homosexual faggot flag up with the White House. That actually happened. This is actually reality. This ain't no like a different dimension we went in a portal, went to the alternative dimension. This is reality. They actually got men marrying men. You actually have a sodomite in the White House. You actually have sodomites walking down the street, kissing each other, being faggots out in the open. That's really going on. You actually got Muslims walking down the street every damn where, looking like we in Saudi Arabia. Bitches walking down the street, titties hanging out, camel toes showing. Oh, go ahead, my fault.
They look at us because these garments, they look at us crazy, but when they see a Muslim with their garments, they don't look at them in no type of way.
Right, they'll make fun of you, but the Muslims look crazy as hell, don't they? They got their whole face covered. All you can see is their eyes, bro. And they'll say nothing to them. Every time I see them, I say, what's up, heathen? And they be stinking, too. Them Muslims be smelling awful. They stink, bro.
Shit, I forgot to. Damn it. Oh, yeah. Okay. This is Nahum 3 and 12. All thy strongholds shall be like fig trees with the first ripe figs. If they be shaken, they shall even fall into the mouth of the eater. Behold, thy people in the midst of thee are women. The gates of thy land shall be set wide open until thine enemies. The fire shall divide the bars.
Yeah, go break that down. The men out here are like women. They soft, effeminate. They're like a bunch of weak, limp-wristed bitches. Scared to stand up for themselves. Scared to speak out against wickedness. Scared to speak out against a wicked government. Scared to speak out against the cops. Scared to speak out against these women, these faggots. The men out here become like women. Just a bunch of soft, weak bitches.
They can't do the thing we do. They can't sit on this side right here and look like fools for Christ's sake.
Because they too effeminate. They too womanly.
But is that going on YouTube?
Probably. We just put them up. We use these videos to help teach brothers the Bible. So it's just for instructional purposes.
But you know that there's at least two churches in every hood.
Yeah, that's why there's still hoods.
That's it. They ain't doing shit.
They teaching lies.
It's like a corner store in every single street. They selling y'all poison, just like the church. They selling you poison. They ain't real church.
Hey, get that Acts 7:48. Check out this scripture, bro. Because the Most High is not up in those churches.
The highest high that you can ever get is up so high, and I don't even know if you're even halfway there.
Most High is in the Creator. He's higher than everybody.
46.
7 and 48.
All right, 7 and 48. Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet. Heaven is my throne and earth is my footstool. What house will ye build me? Saith the Lord.
Yeah, so the temple of the Lord is within you, not in a building. So we're the temple of the Most High, not some little raggedy building up in the hood where Pastor Porkchop take all your money. Tell you it's okay to eat swine's flesh. The pastor will call you a Gentile.
Oh, that matches. All right,
well, before I leave, can I ask you guys one question? A question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
What is the Bible? The man written, right?
Yes, sir. Of course. It's written by men of God.
It was written by men.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why.
That was before man even knew how to write, though, right?
I mean, the Lord gave us that writing. Just like the Lord gave us mathematics, writing, music. He gave us all that.
But the question is so out there, nobody really can answer it.
The Lord left the... He left...
Okay, come on.
This is 1 Corinthians 14 and 37. If any man think himself to be a prophet or spiritual, let him acknowledge that the things that I write unto you are the commandments of the Lord. So one thing the Lord David told him, prophet of the Lord.
And the Lord also came down in a big ass spaceship.
Aliens?
No, see that there's no such thing as aliens. The spaceships or the UFOs.
God.
That's the angels, bro.
What
and the Lord.
Ancient
the ancient Greeks are Israelites. The Bible tells us the ancient Greeks are Israelites.
Okay, so what, they never existed?
No, of course they existed.
Alright.
But they was the Israelites who
they were godlike.
Yeah, they went. We used to, the Bible, hey, get John 10 and 34. The Bible says they were gods. You know that? It says we're gods.
John 10 and 34. Yahushua.
Hey, this is what the one they called Jesus said.
Answered them, Is it not written in your law? I said ye are gods. I just gonna ask you.
It's alright. So the Bible says we're gods, bro. Back in the day we used to have superpowers.
Yeah, we did. And you know what happened? Shut them off.
Yeah, did the Lord. Because we want.
We also know that Adam bit the apple first.
No, that was Eve. Eve ate it first.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Jesus will tell you in Timothy. Cause the snake went to the woman.
What made you think about that? All right, I get it. But while I'm getting it, what made you think about this?
No, so tell me in the Bible.
Second, 1 Timothy 2 and 1 Timothy 2. Cause it says the woman was first in transgression.
Right? Did he not bite the apple?
Yeah, Eve gave it to him. Cause the serpent went to the woman first. Because the woman is easier to manipulate than the man.
Here's 1 Timothy.
Listen to this.
2 and 13. For Adam was first formed, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in their transgression.
Yeah, so Adam, it was Eve who transgressed first. But Adam did eat too, though, so he was guilty of that too.
Right. She manipulated him. Either way.
Yeah,
because.
Yeah.
That's why we don't have powers.
Yeah, we had power even after that, but at that time we was like immortal beings. Because you had King David had superpowers. Samson had superpowers. Samson, that's the mythology of Hercules is based on Samson. That's the same person. Samson is Hercules. What you got?
Well, anyways, man, look, I like having fun with you guys. It's fun. Talking and learning.
Yep. That's all we do.
Here's another scripture. It's Ecclesiasticus 25 and 24. Of the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die.
Yeah, of the woman.
Pandora's box.
Huh?
Pandora's box. What? You ever heard of that?
Yeah, Pandora. You know what that word Pandora means? Pan means all. It's Greek. Pan means all, and Dora means gifts in Greek, so it means all gifts. So really, Pandora's box is the equivalent of the forbidden fruit.
Exactly.
It's the same thing as the forbidden fruit.
So now you know where I'm getting at.
Check this out. You know what a Christmas tree is?
What?
Now, the Christmas tree represents the tree of knowledge of good and evil. That's why they put all those bulbs on it, because those bulbs on the Christmas tree represents the forbidden fruit that the serpent gave to Eve.
Okay.
And that's why they put.
Forgot that being on.
Oh no, I mean, this is going because we're making a lesson. I won't put you on it. It's just for brothers to learn.
Right. Well, I'm trying to learn. So.
Nah, we shooting this. We got to shoot it.
All right, well, fuck it then. VIP ways. Huh? I guess I'm behind the red roses.
It ain't no big deal, man. All
right, nah, here. No, ain't no big deal. All right, so now I got another question.
Because we got brother who depend. They waiting on the videos.
If this is going online.
Yeah.
I got another
question. Hey, when we get you then?
This might say somebody's left. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it probably will.
Maybe what I'm saying. Now, is it or is it not true that human beings can change the same as a brain?
I think that's one of them old ghetto myths. It's not really true. I think they say that to make us think that we're only capable of so much. That's a lie.
But whenever you push your brain to about, let's say, 20%?
Actually, I think most of these people, they only use like 2% of their brain.
Right. Now, if you use 20%.
Yeah.
Let's just make a little scene in our minds here. If you're using 20% of your brain now,
mm-hmm.
Albert Einstein came out with the nuclear bomb. Right? 20%.
You know, Albert.
He did not want the nuclear bomb to come out. He came out with E equals MC squared.
He was actually a fraud. Einstein was a fraud.
Oh, so that was a fraud.
Check this out. He was a so-called Jew.
Then how is it that we have that power to do that?
Because, I mean, he worked at, you know, Einstein worked at a patent office.
You know who Tesla is?
Yeah, Tesla's the real genius. You know what Tesla? You know what Tesla said about Einstein?
What?
He said Einstein was an idiot. Cause Tesla is the true genius.
You know I got a plasma cooler in my house.
Oh yeah.
So what? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, Nikola Tesla is a genius. He's invented. Well, if it wasn't for Nikola Tesla, we wouldn't even have electricity in our house.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
He went back to medicine.
You know where, Edison was trying to rip
Edison
him off.
Edison stole his light bulb idea.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, you know,
now we all know each other.
You know where Tesla said he got all of his knowledge from? Through visions and dreams. Yeah, he got it from the Most High. Oh, yeah, Tesla was, he believed in the Bible.
Way up higher there.
Yes, sir.
He's going right here.
Isaiah 54.
My next
one. Isaiah 54 and 16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire.
The Lord created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire. Like the modern day blacksmith would be the nuclear physicist, scientist. The Lord created them. The Lord is the one who we everybody gets their knowledge from the Most High.
I see you're smarter than what I thought I could be.
Huh. So, you know, a lot of people, they get knowledge while they dreaming. Like a lot of these scientists, the Lord puts it in their spirit to make.
Mind.
Yeah, you know what I mean? They just a vessel of the Lord's destruction.
Right. And they say, thou shalt not disrupt their temple. Talk about the human flesh, the body.
Yeah, the body is the temple.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what the Bible says.
Now, let's say that I do harm this temple. Does the Pharaoh come out? Does the Pharaoh come out?
Pharaoh.
Wait,
where
I'm getting Egyptian times, way back then. Now, they mummified human beings, right?
Yeah, it's pretty weird. The Egyptians are heathens.
Is that so?
Get Egyptians 26 and 6.
Egyptians 26.
I said Egyptians.
So in other words,
Deuteronomy. Now, you know the story of the Exodus. What happened in the story of the Exodus? The story, what happened in the Exodus? The Lord delivered the Israelites from the Egyptians because the Egyptians were oppressors. They were slavers. They was tyrants.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And they didn't have no, all the knowledge they got was from the Israelites. Because it was us that built, we built the pyramids,
but now,
not the Egyptians.
If we go back to Egyptian times, they had electricity.
Yeah, they did have electricity.
Yes, they did.
Everybody in the ancient world had.
Edison.
Yeah, way back, yeah. They had computers.
Right. So how can that happen?
Yeah, actually, they have knowledge in the ancient world that is far surpasses the knowledge we got now. The Bible said there's no new thing under the sun.
It's nothing new.
No, it's nothing new.
In the past.
Right.
Right.
You're right, bro. That's true.
Right. So just keep
they had a
just keep digging back there. Maybe you might just find what you're after.
But the Egyptians though were evil. The ways of the Egyptians is evil. All them Egyptian false gods. They worship cats and bulls. You know, all the pharaohs were married to their biological sister.
And did you also know that cats do have your soul?
I don't know about that. The Egyptians believed that. Hey, get Deuteronomy 26 and 6. Read that.
And the Deuteronomy 26 and 6. And the Egyptians, evil, entreated us and afflicted us and laid upon us hard bondage. And when we cried unto Yahweh, God our Father, Yahweh heard our voice and looked on our affliction and our labor and our oppression. And Yahweh brought us forth out of Egypt with a mighty hand and with an outstretched arm and with great terribleness and with signs, with wonders. And he have brought us into this place and have given us this land.
Yeah, so what's on the back of a dollar bill? A damn Egyptian pyramid.
It actually differs. You can fold the dollar bill in many ways.
Oh man, you can fold it and it shows you the attacks on 9/11 on the dollar bill.
Not just that, but it also shows you some other things.
Yeah, there's a lot of crazy shit on there.
Yeah, in all money.
Yeah, that's because the money is actually a magical talisman used by the devil.
The definition of money is a medium of exchange.
Yeah, it is a medium.
So people came up with money in order to trade for things.
Right, you're right. Yeah, really, originally, real money was originally gold and silver too, not paper. You know what I'm saying? Because the paper is really not money.
Right.
The money we got in our pockets is actually their debt notes. But if you look on the back of it, they tell you what gods they worship.
Right, they're paying it back.
Because do they show you that they worship the gods of the Egyptians? That's why they have the all-seeing eye above the pyramid. And then you got the eagle too. The eagle, that represents Zeus. Because you ever see the Roman armies?
Zeus,
they used to go into battle with an eagle standard. And that's why everything on a dollar is written in Latin. We don't speak Latin. The Romans spoke Latin.
Now you're speaking some real shit.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, that's why. Okay, you know where Capitol Hill is in Washington, D.C.?
Yeah.
That's named after Capitol Hill in ancient Rome, which was the high temple to Jupiter or Zeus. So that the Capitol Hill where the Senate meets, that's actually a temple. Just like the Supreme Court's a temple.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
All the state house downtown. That's a temple.
Right. People don't expect us to know these things, but we do know them. I mean,
yeah, the average person is just a zombie, bro.
Like,
they're goners.
I could have just been an average zombie riding my skateboard down the line.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
A name?
Nah. I ain't got it. He said a knife.
Oh, no.
Hey, we got a sword.
Yeah, something like that. I got a dagger on.
No, we got swords. No, the word
is
the Bible's a sword. The Bible's a sword that chops up people's spirits. Cause there's a scripture that says the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. That's a scripture. It's just you know, we speak in parables.
Hebrews 4:12.
Oh yeah, read this for him. Check this out.
For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow. It is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
Yeah, because this word is powerful, man. That's like all that stuff you talking about, all these mysteries that people don't know about. This Bible is packed full of mysteries.
Right.
All kind of ancient knowledge. You know what I'm saying?
I have one in my bookcase.
And what's that scripture that says, learn the ways of old, the ways of the ancients? Remember, we read that not too long ago.
Now they're coming out with these shows called Ancient Aliens.
Oh, yeah. But you know, the funny thing about that
is some of them are true.
Well, they'll use the Bible to prove that it was ancient aliens, but they'll never use the New Testament because they don't want to talk about so-called Jesus. Because, you know, the Bible's talks about UFOs in the New Testament over and over again. That when the Lord left the earth, he got beamed up. It tells you he got received by a cloud, which is actually a UFO. It said he got beamed. They don't say beam. You should read it, bro. It's in Acts, the first chapter. And it said that when he's coming back with out the sky with legions of angels, and he's going to tread the winepress. So the Lord said, when he comes back, he's coming. How is he going to come out the sky? Come out of the sky with those chariots, so-called UFOs. And that's why when they all this destruction is going down, some of us that are righteous, we're going to get beamed up.
Right. I know you guys are going to get beamed up.
I pray the Lord will beam me up.
I don't know about me, myself.
You never know, man. Oh, if you got faith, the Lord will save you. I know that. Pastor Porkchop ain't getting beamed up.
Well, now, can I tell a little story? Me?
What's up?
It's Jacob.
Jacob? Yeah.
God.
Is that, that's not your real name, is it?
Now, let's just say, when I was 8 years old,
yeah,
I seen a UFO go above my house.
I believe it. I seen one when
so
I was young.
So fucking big, but it didn't make a sound.
Yeah, they're quiet.
At all. No sounds. Now, a man came down.
Oh, man. Shit.
Now, I don't know if it was a human or not.
Yeah.
Now, a man came down, and he said...
Was he black or white?
White.
That was a white dude? Yeah. Oh, shit. All
right, now... Anyways, he comes down, he starts telling me about how I can have my dreams and fantasies and everything. I can have everything. Anything. All I gotta do is sign my name in blood. But now, get this. I'm a leprechaun. So, let's spell it. J-A-C-O-D. But in cursive, you would never notice the difference if you was just quick glancing, right? I tricked the devil.
Now, oh, it was the devil you was talking to?
I don't know who it was.
He said he was a white dude.
I tricked whoever it was. Next thing I know, I wake up the next morning. I'm good as fucking skateboarding. You know? I can skate like I wanted to. Just like I dreamed of. I can rap just like I wanted to. I can rap not only. Now, there's a cross sign. He opened his eyes. Now, when this alien opened his eyes, now he knew what he was seeing inside of me and everything. But he still went through with it. His contract went up in smoke. Thing left. Vanished. Goodbye. Now, I was sitting over my house like a couple of days. Nobody knows.
Okay. So your folks are ready?
That's crazy.
But now that I get a little bit older, I get more bolder, I get a couple of verses from the Bible, Jesus told us, whatever, Romans, ancient Egyptians, I put all the facts together and I got this big ass puzzle. It's 1,000 pieces. I'm only 500 pieces.
We got all the pieces to the puzzle. We got our puzzle. It's on the table. We taped it. We glued it shut. You can't. So you know what I'm saying. You can't lose the pieces. We laminated the puzzle.
I'm sorry.
Then we laminate the puzzle when we're done with it.
Hey, you ever seen Eddie Murphy? We got some eyes.
Yeah, that was.
She was after the ice cream, man, wasn't she?
Damn,
what's
that
ice cream
too? Hell! I didn't see it. I didn't know what y'all talking about.
I have no clue. My day,
how we get into gifts? What God gives you, gifts.
I got Solomon had it when Solomon was about to be king. He had a dream, and in his dream he prayed. He prayed. Guess what Solomon prayed for?
What?
He prayed for knowledge, wisdom, and understanding so he could serve his people.
Right.
And so the Lord, since he didn't pray for money and gold and riches, he didn't ask for that. Since he so the Lord gave him riches. Because he gave him, and he
but
gave him the knowledge. I mean, Solomon was the richest man ever. But I mean, yeah, all this shit out here,
around near death.
This shit's about to be destroyed. And we are all about to be kings.
Armageddon?
Yeah, Armageddon's coming, bro. The America's going to be destroyed in this thermonuclear war because Russia's about to nuke America. That's what's going to happen. They going to nuke the hell out of this place.
But boys, that's why I'm out of here. See ya.
Yeah. This place deserves to be destroyed.
I mean,
it's just fucked up. It's, you know what I'm saying? We're all slaves out here. Everybody's living all
basically
fucked up.
We are. But
basically,
it's in a view that we're not. Now let me explain. Third person view. I'm just another person looking at you.
Yeah.
Just a human being walking down the street. All right, what's up, dude? Goodbye.
Yeah.
That's it. That's what our minds tell ourselves. Now with that 10% being said, now if I use 25%, what's going to happen instead? I'm going to take a hit. Now, I don't mean to run, but I'm going to put this bitch down like a dime. Armageddon, come to me and eat me alive. All my flesh for God. My soul is in God's hands.
But that's what's coming, bro. But you know, before the actual fire comes, shit's gonna get bad out here. Soon, there's gonna be no food in the stores. The EBT is gonna get shut off. You know, EBT cards.
But what's that?
Not ain't gonna, bread. You can't eat it. Yeah, bread would be more valuable.
Not a loaf of bread.
That'd be the most valuable. People will get shot for a loaf of bread.
Right.
People gonna be eating their own children. They gonna run out of food. It's gonna be cannibalism.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's gonna get nasty out here. You ever seen that movie The Rogue?
No, but I might.
But you see what I'm saying. It's gonna get crazy out here. It's like that TV show The Walking Dead.
Yeah, something like that.
Just all survive. Every man for himself. Everybody is surviving.
Yeah, something like that. They're trying to.
There ain't gonna be no women running their mouth no more on that day. They gonna be scared shitless. Humble. Bitches are gonna shut the hell up on that day, bro.
You know what I'm saying? What? This picture right here.
Yeah, right. When the day that happens, you know something's up.
Yeah, Al, you give me that Isaiah 4. Oh, what you about to read? Read it.
I'm about to read it.
Go ahead. Just read that.
2 Ezra 15 and 57. Thy children shall die of hunger, and thou shalt fall through the sword. Thy city shall be broken down, and all thine shall perish with the sword in the field. They that be in the mountains shall die of hunger, and eat their own flesh, and drink their own blood, for very hunger of bread, and thirst of water. And, yeah.
Yeah, that's the point, yeah, because that cannibalism's coming. You know, in ancient Rome, they got siege and their food supply got cut off. They had cannibalism in ancient Rome.
There's three stages, right? The Big Bang. Dinosaurs out.
Huh?
Right?
Huh?
Now hold on. Big Bang, dinosaurs are out.
You know, dinosaurs are still around.
Look. All right, so now there's this. People will survive. That's all I'm getting at. People will come alive. Like, even if they were dead before. And I'm not talking about buried dead, inside dead.
Some call it a valley of dry bones. That's why I call people zombies. It's the walking dead. The walking dead's a metaphor. Because people, they're zombies. They're mindless, walking, talking zombies. They got no purpose. They got no soul. All they do is just obey and just be good slaves.
Scripture says good for nothing.
Yep.
Lost their savior.
Right, but then there's also, have you ever seen what is that movie? The Golden Child.
Yeah. Eddie Murphy movie?
No.
Eddie Murphy's in that, ain't it? With the little bald-headed kid?
I'm not talking about that. No, it's a cartoon type movie.
Oh, I don't know if I've seen it.
They show it in church. Anyways, so there's this child. He's golden. They get rid of him because they don't know what to do with him. They don't know what to do with him. He's too golden, right? So then they ship him down. They're like, oh shit, we got a god on our hands. That's what started the battle. Anyways, man, I'm just having fun, man.
That was cool.
My pleasure, my pleasure.
You from out west? You from out here?
I'm from around here, yeah.
That's how you eat.
Get that Jeremiah 19.
Alright.
Do we have all night? We just come out here, you know what I'm saying, do a little work. And I'm gonna leave, go get some food.
Right. I'm trying to eat too.
Shit. Hey, the Lord said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. The Lord said he's the bread of life. Hey, get that. What's that? You know where that's at? What was you about to read?
Jeremiah.
I got you bouncing all over. John 6. Get John 6.
We're getting into mythical creatures and all that, right?
Right.
So now our minds are open.
Yeah, my mind's very, yeah. All right. What kind of mythical creatures you talking about?
So now.
Some gorgons.
Imagine a leprechaun.
A leprechaun?
No.
That's a drunken Irishman.
No, it's not. That is their disguise.
Actually, leprechauns are probably little demons. You don't think so?
They were sent, yes, they were demons, but they were sent out to retrieve the king's gold.
Well, you know the pictures, the little babies, little white babies that be having
they were
wings.
Sent out.
Yeah.
They were stolen from.
They used to be demons and shit.
Oh, those probably were demons.
They were stolen from. Anyway.
It's like, hold up, you're talking about leprechauns. Down in South America, there's these priests now, the voodoo priests, what do they call them? The shamans. They give you this stuff to drink, some ayahuasca. You ever hear of ayahuasca?
No.
It's got DMT in it. It's one of the most powerful hallucinogens. Down in South America, it's from an ayahuasca vine. You drink this shit, you make a tea out of it. It makes you just trip hard, you just tripping balls for hours and hours. But everybody that says they do it, they all say they see these little men, these little elves, little demons walk around and they talk to them. So that could have a link with the... And now we're off in La La Land, but that could be the same thing as them little leprechauns and Santa's little helpers, the little demons.
Right, but now let me get to my point. Now, these were men, little men, that were sent out from a king that got stolen from. He had magic abilities.
Yeah.
He gave them magic. So now they're all out. Every single one of them died. They didn't get the gold back. Not one time.
Hey, we found the gold.
Now that's where the legend stays. But me, I just like finding four-leaf clovers, you hear me?
What?
Hey. Hey, we got the four-leaf clover. We got the pot of gold.
Yeah.
This is the end of the rainbow is right here.
Rainbow.
It's right here.
Actually,
the name right there.
Is it?
Yeah, it's four letters. The Lord's name's got four letters, like that four-leaf clover. That's that good luck charm.
Is that really?
Yeah, YHW.
What does four-leaf clovers mean, man? I find five at least today.
Hey.
Well, we speak in metaphors and parables, so.
Yeah, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The outside got five letters.
Yep.
J-A-C-O-B. Hebrew though.
Well, his Hebrew in Hebrew is
Jacob.
J-A-C-O-B. Jacob. In Hebrew that'd be Yaquab. God's name's Yahweh. Jesus' name in Hebrew is Yahweh Shah.
Look, man, I don't know about any of this, man. No man does. But now,
sure we do.
Put this shit to rest. I'm sorry. I mean, we're all gonna make our own beds.
Everybody does make their own bed.
We're gonna have to put the sheets on it. We're gonna have to put the pillow down if you're worthy of a pillow, and you lay on it.
Just like the old saying goes, if you lay down with dogs, you'll catch fleas. There you go. Right. So.
So lay down on your bed. You fucking made.
Make sure your sheets is clean. And ain't got doo doo all over them.
Don't piss the bed. Don't shit where you piss.
Don't be having a period blood all up in your sheets. Some dads get STDs and.
Right. Don't shit where you piss. Hey, anyways.
Speaking of parables now.
Can I go off now?
Oh shit. Why? You know,
I want to actually talk.
We talking, bro.
This is. Oh, that. Oh. Gotta wait till it dies or something.
Oh shit, wait till it dies, huh?
It ain't gonna last that long. But we got brothers, they need videos to watch. They hungry.
Alright, well look.
We gotta feed the sheep.
Talk about.
The sheep gotta eat.
Aliens, right?
Yeah, I don't believe in aliens. I don't believe in aliens.
No,
because the aliens is that what they do, because any movie you watch is made in Hollywood or whatever, they always show the aliens as the bad guys. Then Earth goes and fights the aliens. That's because all the governments are actually the devil. And when the Lord comes out the clouds, they're going to tell everybody, oh, we're being invaded by aliens. And they're going to try to fight the angels and the Lord. That's in the Bible. And the Lord's going to destroy them.
Sorry, but you
are. No, you good. Go ahead. All right, what's up? Boom, 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 boom.
So what? They come around. UFOs, all around, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's all cool. But that, you know, everybody knows that. It ain't just in the littlest farm town. It ain't just littlest hometown.
Yeah.
It ain't just all around there. They just pick someone in your fucking town to spread the news around. Now,
hey, you know everybody done seen UFOs. You get on YouTube, UFO sightings are endless. Every day there's a new sighting. So it's indisputable fact. Yeah, it's always on the news, you know. So it's a fact.
You have that blue pair. It would be cute. Or the green.
Because they try to use the aliens. Oh, you ever hear the old slave song? Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Why they sing the chariot? Hey, get Isaiah 66:15 for them. That chariot they was praying for is the chariot of the Lord. That's why they said swing low, because they hoping that chariot come out of the sky, swing low, picks them up, and carries them home. Well, you know, how's that song go? Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Get Isaiah 66:15. But check this scripture out, bro. You want to see about UFOs? Listen to this.
Isaiah 66:15. For behold, Yahweh shall come with fire, and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury, and his rebuke with flame of fire. For by fire and by his sword will Yahweh plead with all flesh, and the slain of Yahweh shall be many.
Yeah, so they said the Lord's chariot will come as fire like a whirlwind.
Right.
And the slain of the Lord shall be many. You know what I'm saying?
Right.